Hi everyone, this is Pawan from SDT channel. In this video, I will talk about JSON basics. Normally, we write text data in many formats like text format or XML format, or in sometimes in database tables and HTML format, etc. So JSON is basically a format where we can write or representing some data. And nowadays, JSON format is also predominantly using in many types of applications and areas. Now let's see the agenda for this session. So first we will see what is JSON and uses of JSON. Then we will see characteristics of JSON, and also we will discuss data types in JSON. And finally we will see JSON syntax. So first, what is JSON? The full form of JSON is JavaScript Object Notation. So JSON is a syntax for storing and exchanging the data. So the format was specified by Douglas Crockford. Basically, it was designed for human readable data interchange, and JSON is a text basically, and which is written with a JavaScript object notation, and it has been extended from JavaScript scripting language. The file name extension is .json, and JSON internet media type is application/JSON. Now, uses of JSON. So where exactly we use JSON? So it helps you to transfer data from the server. And normally whenever we request some data from the server in internet, the data will be transferred in the form of JSON. And JSON format helps transmit and serialize all types of structured data. And it allows you to perform asynchronous data calls without the need to do a page refresh. And especially in AJAX calls, means asynchronous JavaScript and XML. So it is also widely used for JavaScript based application, which includes browser extensions and websites. And you can also transmit data between the server and web application using JSON format. So we can also use JSON with modern programming languages like Java, Python, Ruby, Perl, and etc. And it is also used for writing JavaScript based applications that include browser add-ons. And especially web services and APIs will use this JSON format to get the public data. Now we'll see the characteristics of JSON. So JSON is basically very easy to read and write. Very simple, and it is a lightweight text-based interchange format. And JSON is a language independent, so it supports all kinds of languages, all kinds of platforms. Now we'll see the data types in JSON. So basically JSON is a text, but still it supports certain data types like number, string, boolean, null, object, and array. So these are the types or data types supported by JSON. So whenever you write some data in the JSON format, we have to specify the data types. Now we'll see how we can specify the data by using these data types in JSON format. So the data type. So first one is string. So string is basically a collection of characters that we need to include in the double quotations. So if you see this example, so the complete data will be included in the curly braces. And inside the curly braces, here the name colon John. So here the name is basically the key, and John is a value of the key. So the data will be inserted in the JSON format in the key and value pair format. So here name is a key, John is a data. So this is basically string type of data which we can include in the double quotations. Now the numbers. So numbers can be decimal or integers. So here the age is a key, and 30 is a value, and that is in number format. You can also specify the decimal number. So object. So the values in JSON can be also object. So object is nothing but the collection of keys and values. So for example, here name is equal to John. So this is one data set, and age is 30. This is another data set. Now, if I create a data like this, employee colon and name is John, age is 30, city equal to New York. So all together we can call this one object. This is one object. Now, similarly, we have array, boolean, and null. So array is nothing but it is a collection of values. So for example, I want to store multiple values into a single variable. So I can say employees is my object name colon, and here John, Anna, and Peter. So these are the different values, and this is considered as an array. And boolean. So values in JSON can be true or false. We can also save true or false in a variable. So here this is a sale is a key, and the value of the sale is true. This is the boolean value. And null. Suppose if I don't have any value, and if you don't know the value, we can simply say null. So suppose I don't know middle name. So let's say middle name is a key and the value of the middle name is null. So these are the data types are supported by JSON. Now we will see the syntax of JSON. So how we can write or how we can represent the data in JSON format. So here we need to follow certain rules and regulations. So the data should be in the name and value pairs, or we can say key and value pairs. So for example, here if you see here ID 01. So ID is a key or name, 01 is a value. Name is a name or key, Tom is a value. Last name is a name, price is a value. So these are the data sets. Similarly, ID 02, name and last name. This is another data set. So the data should be in name or value pairs. Now data should be separated by comma. So here ID 01 is one data and another data separated the comma here. So the, here it is a comma. And name is Tom, comma, last name is price. So every data is separated with the comma. And curly braces should hold objects. So if I see here ID, name and last name all together, is a data about one object. So that object should be inclusive in including the curly braces. And ID, name, last name. So this is another object. So including the curly braces. So we can add any number of objects like this. So all these objects we can save in a variable, and that is an array variable. Here the square brackets are representing an array. So in array we can save or we can store values or we can store objects. So currently student is my array, which contains multiple objects. So ID, name, last name, this is one object. ID, name, last name, this is another object. So currently student is my array, which holds two objects. So curly braces should hold objects. So this is a curly brace starting and ending point. Here it contains a value. So this is one object. And here this is another object. So curly braces hold objects and square brackets hold arrays. So this is the basic syntax of JSON. So that's all for this video, guys. In the next video, we will see a few more topics about the JSON. Thanks for watching.